coming up. So if you have a date, which I don't because I only seem to be able to fall for complete douchebags, you've come to the right video. Welcome. I wanted to share with you the look that I do when I want to feel gorgeous and sexy at the same time, together with my gorgeous waves. And I really hope you like it. So if you want to see how this is done, just keep on watching. Because it's coming right after all this. Now.
My favorite foundation from NYX Professional Makeup, this is Total Control Drop Foundation in the shade Medium Olive. I apply it with a tapping motion using this brush that they released together with the foundation. To add some more warmth to my face and also get a head start on contouring, I apply some more foundation in the shade Caramel, and this I do to my cheeks, my temple bones, my forehead, and my nose. Once it's all blended nicely, it is time for the concealer. This is Tarte Shape Tape Concealer in Light Sand. I apply it under my eyes, along my nose, my chin, and my cupid's bow. And then I blend it all together with my beauty blender. To set my base, I use the NYX Professional Makeup Compact Powder in Hashtag No Filter. I use it in the shade Alabaster underneath my eyes, and then I give the rest of my face a light wisp of the powder in the shade Light Beige. For contouring, I have a new favorite. It is the NYX Professional Makeup 3 Steps to Sculpt, and I'm enhancing my cheekbones and I'm slimming my nose. As it is a date night theme, I think blush is very important. It gives a soft and cute impression, so I'm going with this peachy shade in my Sweet Cheeks palette. I actually prefer using this type of brush for my blush, as I think it gives a lighter and more natural spread of pigments. For the eyes, I want a soft eyeshadow look, so I'm using the Fire palette from the NYX Professional Makeup In Your Element series, and I'm applying a light toffee shade in my crease. To create a cut crease, I apply the Shape Tape concealer with a sharp line through half my crease, and then I'm fading it out with my finger. Setting it with a light shade in my contouring palette, and to deepen the outer corner of my eye, I go back in with the powder I used for contouring, as it has a nice and cold shade. Back with the Fire palette, and as we are doing a cat eye, I need a darker brown to lengthen the outer corner of my eye. And I also bring this color a little bit down underneath my eyes. Of course, adding eyeliner, as it wouldn't be a cat eye without it. And who even survives without dreamy, fluffy lashes? I know I don't. To give the look some more intensity, I add black liner to the waterline, and I'm only applying it halfway, and then I'm giving it a little fade with my fingers. Going back in with the light toffee shade under my eyes with a soft blend. Deepening the outer corner with a darker brown, and I'm blending it together with the rest of the eyeshadow. This will make the eyes look a little bit bigger. It needs a little bit more pow, so I sneak in a bit of black and blend it together with the eyeshadow and the eyeliner underneath my eyes. TooFaced Better Than Sex Mascara to give me the long, full lower lash finish that a cat eye look needs. Give all of the lashes a little brush and you're done. With the eyes at least. It is time for the lips and lining the lips with this nude lip liner. If I'm on a date where I will drink and eat, I don't want to have a shade that I will have to think about the refill, so I'm going to go for this new coral pink lippy of mine. It is NYX Professional Makeup in Liquid Suede in the shade Initiator. I think this is the most perfect shade of all. I love it. To make sure the makeup stays flawless all night, I spray my face with a matte finish setting spray. This refreshed feeling is the best of all. Wait for this matte face to dry and then add a little sparkle. I love highlights, so I add it to all places possible. Cheekbones, nose, brow bone, inner corner of my eye, and my cupid's bow. Sparkle away. And this is a look that I would go for on a date night.
It is time to make this hair big and nice and wavy. First step is having a well brushed through hair, and also I suggest having a little bit of dry shampoo in the roots. This will make it easier to get more volume, and it'll be easier to get a big lift when you tease the hair later. I'm gonna use this curling iron. It is new, it is pink, it is pretty, and it is kind of thick. It is 32 millimeters, I think. Yes, it is. And it is the same size top to bottom, which is also important for these waves, as you don't want a cone-shaped curling iron. It'll work, it'll just be a little bit different. But this is the type you want if you have it. I'm going to part my hair in two from right above my ears, and I'm only going to curl the bottom part of my hair up to my shoulders. Having curls in this part will make no sense, it'll have no purpose more than eating up length, and I don't want that. In the top hair, I will tease the roots for volume, and then I will curl them from about my ears because this is where I want the waves to start. But before we go any further, I want to go through the curling technique because that is the most important part of this whole thing. It is what will make the waves look like waves and also save your hair from breakage, which is very important. Twist your hair around the curling iron. Make sure it is flat and not tangled. As there is less hair in your ends than there is in your length, you don't need the ends to be on the curling iron for as long. You carefully touch your hair to know it's not getting too hot. Once it's too hot for you to touch, it's also too hot for the hair to touch the curling iron. Curl the ends for only a second or two and then release. You want to curl all of the hair on your right side to your right and all of the hair on the left side to the left. No cheating, it'll mess up the look, it'll not be the right thing. Treat your hair like you would a relationship. No cheating! Let's get started! So, now you have crazy curly curls and a bubble head and you look like Peggy Bundy, kind of, and that is not the look we're going for. So, bring out your brush, preferably a tangle teaser or something like it, and brush through the whole thing. Wavy, but not quite right. We're gonna do something that I know you're gonna think is crazy and stupid, but it is a big part of this and is what's going to make these waves voluminous. So follow me on this one. Tease the whole thing. Yes, I said it. Tease it, tease it, tease it, tease it. Tease everything, top to bottom, everything.
Written down the words to say, it is time. I've been waiting 5 days to explain how you make me feel inside.
Now you spray for hold. Try not to spray your face. Gorgeous. And now, last step, brush it all through again. Touch my hair, it all goes away. The things I planned, the things I would say. Now I keep rambling on. I sound so cliche. Now it has the volume, so we're going to spray it into place. I'm going to slowly brush it through, use my fingers, my hairbrush, and my hairspray to shape it the way I want it to look once it's done.
You don't know how I shiver inside. Doesn't show, but my nerves are inside out. It's because you're not worth less than perfection. Ooh, thought it was in my pants. Now I'm all confused, turning gold into sand. Don't know what you do to me. All I know is you can take my breath away.
How you make glamorous Hollywood waves. This hoodie, pretty and pink as it is taking the look down, so I need to switch into something more suitable. So this is how I do my glamorous waves. I really hope you like this video and that you get good use out of this tutorial. Date or no date, me, myself, and I'm just going to take nice photos of myself, post them on Instagram, wash this off, pet my cats, go to sleep. That's about it. I really hope you like it. Don't forget to subscribe and I will see you in the next video.